work. If you must know, I'm trying to get this Ash Guardian spell to work. Now let me concentrate.
I don't recall inviting you into my tower. I do hope you make this worth my while. You refer to the tomes of esoteric knowledge that old Hermaeus Mora has scattered throughout the world? What could you know of them? Found one? Yes. And you read it too, didn't you? Don't try to deny it. You've got the look. I can see it now. Dangerous knowledge is still knowledge, and therefore useful. Usually turns out to be the most useful, in my experience. Miraak? The one all the town folk are always chanting about? Well, I knew something connected with Hermaeus Mora was spreading its influence across the island. I wasn't sure that it was in fact the same entity as this legendary namesake of the central temple, although the villagers seem quite convinced. Oh yes, they're not hard to locate once you know how to look for them. I have one here that I've been using to locate more. Yes, I haven't been idle while this fascinating madness engulfed Solstheim. But my book isn't what you're looking for. I'm quite sure it is unconnected with this Miraak. But I do know where to find a black book that can help you. Yes, I do. I haven't been able to get it, though. But maybe together we can unlock the secrets that Dwemer left behind. Forbidden knowledge was somewhat of a specialty of the dwarves, eh? You don't think they would just leave it alone, do you? It seems the ancient Dwemer discovered this book and took it to study. I found their reading room in the ruins of Nchardak. The book is there, but it's sealed in a protective case, which I wasn't able to open. But perhaps the two of us together will be able to get at the book. To Nchardak, then. Follow me.
Mr. Neloth knows what I do. No need to bother him about it, though. He's quite busy at work.
It's on your head if something goes wrong. Just let me get back inside.
No, Ash Guardian. Maybe the book has something.
Warhammer certainly knew how to build for the ages. These towers have outlasted their creators by millennia. The book is housed inside that dome. I'll need to unlock the door for us. Let's get on with it. Here we are, Nchardak. The book we're after is right inside that dome. Shall we get on with it? The Dwemer of Nchardak appear to have been fogged on these control pedestals. Luckily, I found a cube to operate it inside on my last visit. I sealed the door when I left to keep out ignorant meddlers. Let me unlock it. The book is just inside. So tantalizingly close. But trust me, no magic will open that. I'd have had the book already if it could. No, we'll have to do this the hard way. If we can restore the steam supply to this room, I'm certain I can open it. As you'll see, that's easier said than done. This way to the boilers.
Going forward, be aware that red control pedestals are activated by, but don't require a control cube to remain in place. You'll retain the cube after activation. Blue pedestals, however, require the control cube to remain in place and they must be retrieved manually.
Explored a small part of the ruins. I was here alone then, and I find an assistant is absolutely essential for this kind of dirty, dangerous work. Nchardak, the city of 100 towers. In its day, it was the largest of the great Dwemer archives, and perhaps the most advanced. In the old stories, when the Nords came to conquer it, it said that Dwemer submerged the entire city beneath the sea until the invaders gave up. I have my doubts, but the city was a marvel of Dwemer engineering. Now reduced to this. As you can see, most of the lower levels of the city are flooded, but it isn't hopeless. The old Dwemer pumps still seem to work. Watch. But the pumps only operate when a cube is in a pedestal.
Unfortunately,
we only have one cube. These four boilers provide steam to the room upstairs. They're shut down, but they still respond to the control cubes. So, if we can find four more cubes, we can turn these boilers back on and restore steam power to the room upstairs. Then I should be able to open the book's protective case. Bring that cube. We'll need it. The flooding before the city was abandoned. Interesting. That would suggest that the city must have originally sunk during the first cataclysm of Red Mountain. Or that the Dwemer's servitors continued to try to preserve the city after their creator's disappearance. Three of the cubes are through here. This seems like a sensible place to start. These must be the great workshops of Nchardak. Impressive, even in ruins. In the city's days of glory, it was reputed to be able to assemble a complete autonomy in a single day. Much of the Dwemer's army at the Battle of Red Mountain must have come from here.
So you
trip!
Let's see where this leads. guess that must be the pump activator up there. But how to reach it? We'll need to get all three of these bridges. That's it. Don't touch anything else. Quickly now. You'll need the cube I picked up to start all the boilers. Here, I picked up this cube for you. Shall we get off with it?
better than I am. But at least it's finally done.
Look out! Another steam centurion!
I'm going to head back upstairs and see if the reading room has steam. So, it should be a simple matter to release the book. It could be very dangerous. Books are known to thrive.
I know you, champion. The Agma Infirm was only the beginning. This is Apocrypha, where all knowledge is hoarded. Sate your thirst for knowledge in the endless stacks of my library. If you tire of the search, read your book again to return to your mortal life. For a time, the lure of Apocrypha will call you back. It is your fate.